David, the great king of Israel, once said that my times are in thy hands. Friends, it was on Thursday, the 8th of September, at approximately 6:30 in the evening, that our nation was informed of the death of our gracious Majesty, Queen Elizabeth II. 96 years of age, on the Balmoral estate in the Highlands of Scotland, our Queen took her leave from this old world in which we live. She had served our nation with honour, with distinction, and with great integrity for 70 long years. In fact, she became the longest serving monarch that has ever served throughout British history. Her faithfulness in service and her dedication to duty was evident for all the world to see. While still a young princess, she declared to the entire nation that her whole life, whether it be long or short, would be devoted to your service and to mine. She truly went the extra mile and beyond the call of duty in fulfilling that pledge to the nation. As a nation and as an Orange institution, we salute her memory today. As a people, we have entered into a time of great sadness and deep mourning. However, we are very mindful not only of the grief and hurt being experienced throughout the nation, we're also conscious of the grief that is beheld in the royal household and especially in the House of Windsor. We assure them of our prayerful support as they endeavour to come to terms with the loss of one who we all knew so well and we loved so much. All the virtues and all the values that we embrace as a nation could be found in the life and in the character of our gracious Queen. We, of all the nations of the world, have been so blessed to have had Elizabeth the Faithful as our sovereign upon the British throne for so long. And as we mourn her passing today, we are encouraged by the many times throughout her long reign when she referred to her unwavering faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Who could ever forget those many occasions when she addressed the nation at Christmas and she spoke of the Lord Jesus as being the only Saviour of the world. It was heartwarming and it was breathtaking to hear our gracious Queen speak of the teachings of Christ being the bedrock of her personal faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. As most recent as just a few weeks ago, Her Majesty stated that throughout her life, the message and teachings of Christ have been her guide and that in them she found hope. Such assurance of a personal faith grounded upon the scriptures will, I'm sure, come as a great source of comfort to her family as they try to come to terms with this sad loss. And yet, in spite of Her Majesty's position and power, in spite of her place of prominence within the nation, she too had to go the way of all men. The Bible says that it is appointed unto men once to die. And this appointment with deity that was made away back in the annals of eternity could not be rearranged, it could not be rescheduled, not even for our gracious Queen. The Bible speaks of a time to be born and a time to die, of a time to plant and of a time to pluck up, of a time to weep and of a time to laugh, of a time to mourn and of a time to dance. We are reminded in the book of Proverbs, boast not thyself of tomorrow, for we know not what a day may bring forth. And so when the heart of the nation is so tender as we mourn the loss of our Queen, it surely begs the question today, where will you spend eternity? When it comes to your appointed time to leave this old world in which we live, friend, how will it be with your soul? Well, let me be very clear today that our decision this side of eternity will determine our destiny in the life hereafter. We have been instructed in God's word that we must prepare to meet our God. I wonder if have you made any attempt to prepare for that time when you will stand before the King of Kings and Lord of Lords and give an account of the deeds done in the flesh? Friends, if we fail to prepare, then we must be prepared to fail. I wonder, have you a personal faith in the Lord Jesus Christ? Do you know anything of what our Queen spoke of when she said that the bedrock of her faith was the Scriptures? Do you know anything of this personal relationship with Jesus Christ being the only Saviour of the world? Beloved, the Bible says that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. He came to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself. And he came to bear your sins and my sins in his own body on the tree. Will you not call upon him today? Will you not trust him as your own and personal Saviour? Because one day, someday, you too, just like our most noble and illustrious Queen Elizabeth, will go the way of all men. And you must be accountable in that day when we will stand before the Lord as to what we have done with Jesus, which is called Christ. While the nation's thoughts are turned today to the brevity of life, to the certainty of death, to the reality of God's eternity, why not trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding? In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Our gracious Queen is dead. May God be pleased to bring salvation to the heart and soul and life of Charles III. And may God save our gracious King.